So the final part of the video, we are going to show how we are going to connect the 4K camera head and its leg guide to any rigid scope or any fiber optic scope which you are having. It can be a flexible scope also. And right now I am going to first show you how we are going to do it with the demo laparoscope. We have a 0 degree laparoscope, so we are going to make use of it and show you the clarity. But for a kind understanding, this is not bundled along with the package. You need to use your own scope. We are just going to show the functionality, how it's going to be used. So, this is the 4K camera head. You will get one of the best outputs, the best clarity and resolution from this camera head. And you have to make sure that the scope you are using is also free from damage and it is compatible with this camera head. See, it's a 22mm dia camera head. The scope which you are having also should be compatible with this base. And whenever you are handling the light guide, be very extra cautious. Even if you drop it once, the light bundles is not going to work. So you can see, this needs to be handled very carefully. And in the previous video also I told you, the longer tip was used for the light guide and the smaller tip was used for the air water feeder pump. So obviously when you're going to do laparoscope, you are not going to need any suction or any air water feeder, which you're going to use it separately. So we are going to attach this into the light source of our processor. Be very careful, it will go in only one unidirection. So you need to press it. That's it. So already that is done. And the other end of the light guide, we are going to connect it on the scope. So this is the 0 degree laparoscope. Be sure to remove the tip and keep it safe, so that after the procedure you will need it. Make sure to connect it properly and rotate it clockwise. So now we are going to connect the camera head. So until before this, when we connected all the video scopes, we were using a signal cable and the signal cable was connected to the scope. But here you can see, the signal cable is directly attached to the camera head. So our process is very simple. We are just going to connect this tip directly to the processor. And like in our previous videos, make sure to see the red color marking and press it gently into the processor. Make sure to align it. Yeah. And give a small push. Next, remove the camera head protector case. You need to press both these hinges together so that the camera head is now open. So first, before connecting to the scope, let me just simply switch on and show you the clarity, and next we will connect it to our scope and we will check the clarity. Okay, so I'm going to switch on the processor. Okay, and now you can see an image. And the only difference between using the video scopes and using the camera head is that all the video scopes are autofocus. You don't need any adjustments. Whereas in the camera head, you can see a rotary dial. And once you change it clockwise or anti-clockwise, the focus changes. And now see, I'm just on the display, I'm just focusing on my window. And now automatically when I rotate, I'm bringing it into the focus. And you can check out the clarity even from a good considerable distance. You'll be able to get the best clarity in the camera head. I'm focusing on the Hugo brand image. You can see the letters crisp and sharp. And you can see the light guide which is being connected. And everything, I'm doing it from a considerable distance of almost 1 feet. Okay, now let us see how the resolution stands when we connect it to the scope. So I'm going to remove the scope opening, keep it aside, and again make sure to press both these buttons together, keep the scope inside and close it. And now finally remove the scope tip. Finally your video laparoscope is ready. And in order to focus, just make use of any object. Here also we have to do auto white balance. So as I was telling you, we have to follow all the standard procedure, like choosing the auto white balance and choosing the required amount of LED intensity. The main thing is that one extra thing which you need to do in the lap when you are using the camera head is that you need to make sure the focus is proper. So adjust the manual focusing until you are sure about the image. And now you can switch on the LED lights first, and you can change the LED intensity, and now you can see the LED tip being illuminated, and check the clarity on the screen. And I'm adjusting the focus. Yeah, and now you can see the clarity. So whichever existing rigid scopes you are having of 22mm base, or whichever fiber optic scopes which are flexible or rigid, whichever the existing scopes, you can use it with our camera head and the light guide, so that everything can be converted to a video scope. And the same way, now in order to record the pictures and save the videos, here also you have been given a dedicated button. You need to press it once and automatically the picture is going to get saved. And if you want to record a video, the same button needs to be long pressed. If you're going to long press and leave it, the video recording is going to start, and again when you long press it, the video is going to get stopped. So that is the only difference between the using the camera head and the other video scopes. There is only one button for the file image capturing and video recording. And again I will show you all the disconnecting procedures also. So first main thing, you have to lower the LED intensity, switch on the LED light source, and before disconnecting all the peripherals, make sure to power off the monitor, and then carefully remove the scope from the camera head. Keep the camera head safe. And finally, when you are removing the light guide also, make sure to properly unscrew it in the anti-clockwise direction and keep it safe. So that is basically, we have covered about the processor, we have covered about the video gastroscope, video colonoscope, video bronchoscope, and we have also seen how to use the 4K camera head and the light guide along with your existing scopes. Once you switched off the main power supply, and once you remove the scope, make sure to remove the camera head and the light guide from the system. And like in our previous videos, make sure to gently pull it outside, and lock the camera head so that the lens is not damaged. You need to press this button. Cover the lens. Yeah, that is firmly fit. And next, removing the light guide, be very careful. Press one finger against the processor and straight away remove the light guide. Yeah. Once it's removed, make sure it is firm and make sure there's no blockage or anything. And keep the light guide also safe, and cover the light guide tip also. Once you remove it, thank you. So it's a complete all-in-one package. It's a fully mobile unit, and it's one of the best resolutions available in India at the entry level endoscopy systems. And any doubts or any queries, you can either comment below, or you can call us directly at 7397 44991. Thank you so much for watching this, and We are happy to serve you. Thank you.